12-year-old puppets. Tangled in strings.
Paraskeptix again, coming to you from beautiful downtown Vortex, Arizona. Look that one up. You'll never find it.
How the hell are we doing out there? This is Dalton. I'm a little under the weather, and your mom's a little under me, so it all evens out.
That's the balance of the universe right there. It's the beauty of it.
It's the balance of the force.
That's what we're here for.
Boy, we have had a fucking interesting week, Skeptoids. It's been interesting. We told you that this was going to be the year of the skeptics, and so far, it has lived up to the hype.
Yeah, it has. It's been nuts.
We're getting more shit coming out of the woodwork, folks, than we have ever had. And not only that, we were talking about it before the show, we've been at this for a full year.
Yeah.
So how about that? This is the Paraskeptix anniversary show.
Please, don't stand up.
Send us shit.
Send us, yeah. Fund me.
For all the year, for the past year of enjoyment that we've given you, fund us. Why not?
Send us your firstborn.
But it really is. It's been crazy. Apparently, we've been recommended for talking to some John Tenney. To which I replied, who the hell is John Tenney? And after doing a little research, I still don't know who the hell John Tenney is. But apparently he put it out there that he's looking for a skeptic show to come on. We were recommended to him. And he thumbed it up. He was like, yeah, sure. But, you know, we ain't heard a goddamn thing from him. So, John Tenney, put up or shut up, buddy. Come talk to the skeptics.
I send him a message. We'll see if he wants to talk with us. Hey,
we'll give you your venue, buddy. You want to talk to a skeptic? Talk to, and you know what? While we're talking about it, we have told you, dumbasses, this. I don't know how many times, and I say dumbasses as lovingly as possible. Dumbasses.
You just don't get it, do you? You don't.
We are not skeptical of the paranormal. We have told you stories of our experiences with the paranormal. We still investigate. We got an investigation coming up on the 20th of February. Okay? We do investigate. We still go out there and investigate.
Yeah, we've seen witness shit, so it's not like Paraskeptix. Your medicine for paranormal bullshit. That's what we're here to weed out the shit. You know, because the limelight is focused on the shit artist, and they're mucking it up.
And we have told you people this, I don't know how many times, but you just don't fucking listen, do you?
and for anybody that wants to talk, the word that we, you know, approach to talk, it's like we've always said, you... If you're legitimate, then you've got nothing to worry about. You got nothing to fear. So, there.
That's right. Sack up. We're just as interested in the paranormal as you are.
Yeah, exactly. And, I mean, we want to get down to the bare bones and talk with people who've experienced and who are part of a legitimate something.
But see, here's the difference between us and you, okay? When we say we're interested in the paranormal just like you, there is a slight difference, okay?
Just a little bit.
Hey, Wade, how much money have we made off this show?
Let me check. Let's see. Zero. $0 and 0 cents.
Oh, so that means we do it for the love of it, right?
Pretty much.
That's the difference between us and you assholes. You do it because you want it to be a job. And that's something like what we're going to talk about today. We talk about puppetry. How most of you are puppets. And we'll get into that. But we're not going to start on that yet.
Oh, yes.
One thing I have to say is, last week, you heard the show. Wasn't going to name names. Fuck it. I'm in a mood. I'm going to name some names. Hell's Bar Dam and Marina is fucking fake. Am I making that up, Wade?
No.
No, I'm not. And I didn't come out and make that up myself. We were told that. By Stormy Knight. Look at me, I'm Stormy Knight.
Stormy McKnight.
Okay, like, we don't know that fucking name is made up. Nobody named their kid Stormy Knight unless they're a dumbass.
I've got the perfect name, Storm Knight, but our last name is Weber. I don't care.
I don't care.
It's Stormy Knight.
We're gonna name him Storm Knight.
Mother of God.
Storm Knight. Fuck you. Alright. Hell's Bar is fake. He told us. Flat out. And if you don't believe us, there will be a write-up coming soon from a very good friend of the show who has all the documentation proving that the story that they put forward is bullshit.
That's information that even back in the... I forgot who the hell was the previous owner or what, whatever you want to call it. Whoever was running the show when Ghost Adventures came on, they were. It's the same story you'll see with that was given to the Ghost Adventures team.
The one that Ghost Adventures used on the show like it was legit.
Yeah,
which tells you that they didn't do their homework.
No, they just went with it. Yeah, sounds good. Go.
It's good TV. I like the story.
Yeah.
Are you going to research it? Nah, I was too busy having breakfast. Okay, so not only are we debunking that place, we're debunking the shows that have been there and called it legit.
Yeah, and that includes all you YouTubers.
Imagine that. So,
all the YouTuber investigators that went there, you got... If you got a voice, I'll tell you where that fucking voice was.
Hey, yeah.
It's a giant concrete building.
It was the people doing ghost tours.
In the tunnels below.
Down in the tunnels, because we thought we heard it too. We were like, oh, you hear that? That's a straight up conversation. It was a straight up conversation from people in another part of the building. the place is such a pain in my ass. But we're not going to talk about that. We talked about that last week. Just naming names. Hell's Bar. Fake. Fuck it. Okay. Now, you know, we tie our intros into kind of what we're going to talk about on the show. And what we've done is, we try to make you people get out of your funk. Okay? You guys have become puppets. You've become...
The sheep. Some here sheep.
I don't know. I don't know if you're trying to become mirror images of what you see on TV. You know, this is the way Taps does it. This is the way Zach Bagans and them do it. So this is the way I got to do it.
Yeah.
And the thing is, we're guilty of it too. We were guilty of it at one time because we were on.
Yeah, we were
a team.
Part of a Taps affiliated team, and you know, and it's like, ah, well, I'm doing this shit. Ah.
So we're just as guilty. So that's why we feel like we can talk about it, because we've done it. At one time, we were no better than you. Well, we've always been better than you. But you know, we were just as guilty of the same shit as you are. And what we want to do, you can ask people that have investigated with us. Okay, our investigations are very loose, very laid back, very relaxed. It's not very formulaic. It's not a whole bunch of, you got to do this, you got to do that. Because all that shit, all that does is take the fun out of what you're doing and make it seem like a job.
Yeah, there's too much. If you get too formal and you have to do everything routine, everything, that, and it's all emulated from what you've seen on TV. And
that's exactly what it is. And if you say it's not, you're a damn liar. How many of you go out and buy equipment because you saw it on a TV show?
Yeah, exactly. And how many people are saying that you approach your investigations very scientifically or use a scientific method? It's probably because these guys on, you know, certain TV shows are doing it, and so it sounds pretty good to throw that in your description.
All you do is make yourself seem like a pretentious cocksucker.
Yeah, I know.
I don't take you serious. If you come to me, and me, anybody that has some little bit of sense about them knows that there's no proof or there's no science to back up anything to do with ghosts or poltergeist activity. There's theory. There's theory about what it is.
A lot of theory.
Just like poltergeist, okay? It comes from a German translation, you know, noisy ghost. That's what it means. Poltergeist. That's the literal translation of poltergeist. Noisy spirit. Noisy ghost. Somewhere along the lines, that got tied into some prepubescent fucking girl going through puberty. Where the hell did that come from? Who the hell?
It was a conjuring derived from mood swings.
And how many of you have used that? And if you say you hadn't, you're a damn liar.
Yeah.
How many of you have called in? Okay, all right, we've got a case. We've got a potential case. What we need our case manager to call, and we need to have you talk and interview the client, the potential client. Okay? And say, well, we got stuff being moved around. Are there any young girls in the house? Well, I'm not answering that, creeper. I mean, come on. Get real, people. Who gives a shit who's in the house? Who cares? Just go in there and, first off, be honest with the people. You know, we can't promise you we're going to catch shit. Say, look, all we can do is try to come in and document what you say you got going on. Okay, then we'll bring in some fake-ass shaman who swears up and down they're related to Indians, and they're going to do a sage. They're going to burn sage, and that's going to clean the house and make the spirits come back. Yeah, and then what? A month from now, when the shit hits the fan again, because you can't remove spirits. You can't do it. You can't fucking do it. Oh, do you think you can do it? How many times have you heard a fucking ghost story where they have somebody come bless the house, and guess what? The shit still happens.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and they have the asshole on TV. I can feel it. They're gone.
Yeah.
It feels
lighter in here, doesn't it?
You feel that? It feels like, because it's a state of mind.
Yeah.
Because it's your belief. Okay, I've got a priest in here. He blessed the house. The power of God has blessed this house, and this house should be clear. And then you feel all good about yourself and everything's good to go. And then a month later, you notice the shit's still going on. Because you can't do it.
Yeah, it doesn't happen like that. You know.
You know, and like we've said in the past, and we may be touching on some stuff we talked about in the past, but fuck it, because you people aren't changing.
Yeah, as long as it remains, if it stays on the same path, we're going to stay on the same path to get that shit changed.
Believe me, in person, we're nice guys. You can ask the people that have talked to us and dealt with us. We're fucking awesome dudes.
You could talk to the folks that I was at home with.
You can ask the people that I held hostage in that home invasion.
Yeah.
I was very nice.
Yeah.
I raped the dog. So what?
You know?
That bitch had it coming. You see what I did there? That was nice.
Yeah, good.
But we would love to get on here and just expound about the positivity and all. No, we wouldn't.
That just doesn't, yeah, it doesn't feel right. It's in fact, it was, that was a thing that is, certain places that we've, visited and where they said they had some kind of dark entity, creating havoc, and then we experience absolutely nothing. And my theory is that it saw the negative energy approaching it, and it's like, I gotta get the fuck out of here.
Son of a bitch, it's the skeptics.
Jesus Christ, I thought I had a bad day.
We may not be that popular here in the real world, but on the other side, Jack, they know us real well.
They can. In fact, some of them really like us.
We got kind of a reputation on the other side.
He's got friends on the other side.
So, but, excuse me.
You will not die.
What I wanted to say is what we do in our investigations is we've cut the cord. We've given up on trying to emulate the TV shows and following their protocols and all this shit. And what I've noticed is that I have fun now. When I investigate, investigating is fun now. And I'll tell you something else, too. When we investigate, we don't fucking beat around the bush. All right? That ghost has got a fucking 2-hour time limit. Motherfucker, if some shit ain't happening in a couple hours, Jack, I'm looking at getting the fuck out of there.
Yeah, I mean, who says, well, I know who says, but you don't have to follow that, you know? The people that make these rules aren't any smarter than you. Some of them might be, but you don't have to sit there all fucking night until 3 a.m. in the morning, and
that's
if
right.
The place is fucking haunted, something's going to happen, whether it be day or night. Don't, you know, don't tell me otherwise, because that's bullshit.
And now, let me ask you this. Before the concept of dead time, okay, was introduced, you know, at one time the witching hour was midnight.
Yeah.
Then, you know, it was pushed back to 3 a.m. because that's dead time. What? Who? Why?
Yeah, what? Where'd that
come
from?
How do you even know spirits can tell time? What if they have no concept of time?
Do they have ghost watches? What the fuck?
You know, I really like this Citizen Echo drive. It runs straight off my ectoplasm. Yes. I never have to get a battery.
Ecto drive.
Ecto drive. Patent that. But seriously, folks, have you ever really consciously sat and asked yourselves why you do some of the shit you do on investigations?
Yeah, it's, I mean, with the team that we were previously with, I mean, there was too much, it started to get to be too much paperwork. I mean, there was actually, you know, it's like, you know, my God, how freaking strict and, you know, uniform do you have to be with this? It's not gonna help you weed out any crackpots at all. I mean, it's, you're still gonna go through all this headache and still get some shit.
I mean, it was so bad that if somebody caught an EVP on this team, it would then have to be backed up with somebody else's recorder in the same area at the same time.
With a retarded file naming system.
And if you couldn't provide a backup EVP from someone else's recorder at the same time in the same area with the same timestamp, it was thrown out. And another thing. EVPs, if you know, the whole Class A and Class B and shit, if you have to tell somebody what the motherfucker's saying, give it up.
Good point.
Give it up.
We listened to this about 60, 65 times, and we think it's saying, hello, how are you?
And I know we've already mentioned the name, but quit fucking calling yourself specialists.
Yeah.
Like, there's something different you do that you step in and all of a sudden all hell breaks. Fuck yourself.
I'm an EVP specialist. I'm a tech specialist.
So look, here's what we're talking about this week, folks, okay? This is what we want you to try, all right? Cut the damn cord, okay? Stop being a puppet to all these parapersonalities, and you can like them all you want. That's fine. We don't care. We're not going to knock you much for liking. We like some of them, maybe.
Possibly.
I don't really know any of them. But
a smidge.
We've talked to a couple of them. And one-on-one, they can be all right, decent people. I've said it before, I'll say it again. Pari seems to be an all right guy.
Yeah.
As far as I can tell, he's a legit dude. And we've met some cool people in the paranormal field. And I'm not saying they're all crazy. Okay? And we're not hard to get along with. Matter of fact, we're going to have a Google Plus Hangout next week.
Ah, yes.
Okay, if you want to know something about us, if you want to talk to us, if you want to see if we're not as bad as you may think we are, because we've met some people through this show, and they're friends of ours now. Cool people that we would hang out with outside of doing paranormal shit. Okay? We're not bad people. We're just fed up with your bullshit. We want you to cut the cord, folks. Get back into the paranormal to have fun with it. Quit thinking that you're going to be the one that, after all these years, proves the existence of spirits and that you're going to be some millionaire because you got this fancy piece of evidence. Mm-hmm. You'll never be able to do it.
Yeah, and how many times have you heard a group say something, their intro, whatnot, whether it be a damn YouTuber or, a networked, ghost hunting show. I'm in the paranormal because I'm here to find answers.
They've been trying that shit for fucking decades, Jack.
Yeah, you know what? You're not going to find any answers. And what is the question?
There are no answers to be found. That's the kicker. There are no answers to be found.
See, what I imagine your mindset is too, it's not to go and find, I'm using little quote fingers, I'm not to go find answers. I'm going in to confirm that this shit is happening, because, here and there, I didn't have as much crazy experience as you did, but I've encountered some things here and there, and to go, example again is this place in Kentucky we went to, and to encounter stuff that we did that night is just a confirmation. I'm like, son of a bitch. holy hell. Exactly what I knew this is happening, but I just want to make sure that I'm not fooling myself. And
it gets under your skin, man. You get a little bit of it, you got to get some more. You got to get back in there. You got to experience it again. But it's just that, an experience. That's it. You're not going to get some knockout piece of evidence that's finally going to prove everything. You know how I know that? Because people are too fucking gullible. Okay? If you don't believe me, I want you to go out to YouTube and I want you to look up the 5 best ghost videos. Okay? And some of that shit is so blatantly edited and CGI'd, it's not even fucking funny. Oh, we're not talking about nowadays level CGI. We're talking like early 90s CGI.
It's bad.
It looks like fucking Gumby out there.
Oh, they're so blatantly faked. Yeah.
And people are calling that some of the best evidence. According to who? According to you, Mr. Channel Owner?
Yeah, no kidding.
Well, son of a bitch, you've got all the answers, Jack. We should have just talked to you from the start. You could have just saved us all the trouble. Quit acting like you're professionals. You're not professionals. You have a hobby. admit you have a hobby, and have fun. That's it. And very simple.
And stop trying to produce these little chintzy videos on YouTube thinking that you're going to get seen and noticed and some sci-fi is going to call you up and say, hey, you want to be on a show?
And there's another.
Well, there's another.
Give up on the damn. Give up on the shows. We still got to come back and talk about shows because there's more shows. Well, no, there's not more shows now. There's the same shows. They just have new names.
Yeah, it's the same shows with new names. Tons of them. Fucking Destination America. Fuck you.
And we got some good stuff coming about that, too. We got some parodies coming.
Oh, yeah, we have a winner.
We've got some Destination America parodies coming, folks. Look for that real soon. We're going to get back out
Productions.
There. We're going to get back out there. We're going to get back to filming, and we're going to get back to having some fun.
And speaking of sci-fi and puppets, this is a little proof of the puppetry out there because people buy into this, you all. And there's one person, actually there's a handful of people that we see that we notice on the Twitter world, and they are a couple of them are associated or might be on some of these ghost hunting shows, and if you look at the talent involved, they're fucking actors. And I'm like, all right. So, this person's been in a sci-fi paranormal reality show. I guess they're an investigator. But why is his resume a fucking acting? As an actor, okay, interesting. So but you people buy it, and you think it's real, and it's not. Basically, reality TV is fake, but. The paranormal is more so. Ghost Hunters, the first two seasons maybe seemed kind of on the level, but after that, it's just.
And even they claim to catch something in Hell's Bar.
That's right. Holy hell! I forgot about that.
Go figure on that. Okay, but we just want you guys to have fun. Have fun. Remember why you got interested in, and some of you don't know, some of you fucks don't know any better. Okay, because you didn't get interested in the paranormal until the shows. Okay? You're bandwagoners.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think it's kind of cool.
Question yourself whether you have a legitimate interest in the paranormal or whether you have a general crush on Zach Bagans. Because let me tell you something, I used to get, before he blocked us, okay, we used to see that shit of people like, good night, my dark prince.
Yeah, what? The fuck?
Good night, my dark, what? That's not stalkery at all.
Oh, God.
No way would we ever expect to see you on How to Catch a Predator.
Yeah. Seriously.
People are delusional. Especially when you go talking about how these people care about you. They don't give a shit about you. They don't know who you are. And don't care. That's the bitch of it. And you think they do, but they don't. They just... Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, saying them all.
That's another show.
It is. There's so much. And if and that's the thing, as long as these shows keep going, we're gonna they just keep feeding us. And we're probably, speaking of shows, this is we're probably going to do another Exorcism Live type show. We just have to find the right show. It'll present itself, believe you me.
And let me just go ahead and say this while we're at it. If you are a jackass and you make little comments like, oh, why is there so much talking? Because it says in the title, commentary.
Yeah.
Okay? That means we are watching it and we are commenting on said show.
Yeah.
okay? That's why our schools are in the shit tank. Because we're churning out fucking retards.
Oh, fuck.
If you see it, say commentary. Yes. And you don't want to hear a commentary, you might want to look for another video. Little disclaimer.
Little details. Oh, man. I forgot. I just got a little notification here. You know what it's time for?
What's that?
Our brand new segment.
You know what it is.
Yep.
Folks, what we did is we sent out I'm glad she reminded us because we almost forgot.
She's going to be pissed.
No longer. Don't tell me how long she's been waiting. We actually looked out. We know that the paranormal happens all over the world. So what we did is we reached out to someone and we wanted to have them on as a foreign correspondent to cover overseas paranormal for us. And we got someone from Scotland who was going to help us out. And she's actually going to be phoning in right now. And we're going to bring her in and we're going to listen to her. She's going to tell us about some stuff going on over there. Let's bring her in.
She's an awesome worker. Great family woman. She's married. Has two kids. We've talked to them all. We did a little Skype chat with them and it's an awesome family. And, she does good work. She's a little ornery, but.
Oh man. Let me tell you something. Her kids, beautiful, beautiful kids, beautiful family. I mean, picturesque family, man. Yeah, okay. And see, this is showing you that the skeptics have heart.
See? Yeah.
Okay, because we're all about it. Let's get her in right now, and let's see what she's got to say.
You couldn't find a better reporter out in the field. Let's hear it.
Right, you wee bastards. I've got something to say. I don't...
Allahu Akbar!
Oh, son of a bitch!
Holy shit.
You gotta be shitting me! She had our equipment!
She had our laptop, man. How much shit did we have on that?
You gotta fucking kidding me.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, it's not the religion. My fucking ass is not the religion.
Wait, did we pay for that flight?
That's our whole chef budget for the...
All right.
Well,
I guess we're going to have to fucking put out another ad. Shit.
Oh, man. You may be saying, well, what about a fucker family? She had our equipment. What the fuck? Well, it looks like we got an opening, folks. Yes. That was kind of unforeseen.
If you have any experience in journalism or if you're a gas station attendant.
Yeah, but due to unforeseen circumstances, we're no longer going to be able to supply you with skeptics equipment. So you're going to have to use your own because that shit just got really expensive.
Yeah, that really put a hole in the pocket there. Fucking hell.
Son of a bitch.
All right.
Fuck it.
Well, see, the show with the skeptics, we start with a bang and end with a bang.
That was nice. Yeah. Yeah. This is a tragedy.
Yeah, it is. Lost some sales bar. Oh god.
I think she had my pimp.
Oh shit. Would you like to have a career with the Paraskeptics? It appears an opening has arisen. You can send your name and information to 101 Black Hole Vortex, Arizona. Banks
and by yon bonny breeze, where the sun shines bright on Loch Lomond, where me and my true love will never meet. On the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond.